And I'm going to present a lecture series on genetics using whiteboard. Perhaps it makes the matter more interactive and hence more helpful in making knowledge available very easily for the students. So let us start the description. It is prokaryotic transcription. So, whatever genetic information that is present on DNA molecule, this genetic information is transcribed in the form of mRNA. M, that is, this M stands for messenger RNA molecule. So, genetic information is transcribed in the form of mRNA. So, the process is called as transcription. And then, from mRNA, this information is converted into a polypeptide chain or protein and the process is called as translation. So, genetic information present on DNA is, first of all, it is converted into mRNA molecule and then into a protein. This is called as central dogma. It is called as central dogma. So, genetic information, whenever it is expressed, it is always expressed in the form of proteins. So, expression of genetic information is in the form of proteins. Whenever DNA is expressed, proteins are produced. Only exception is rRNA molecules and tRNA molecules. Some of the genes, they code for these two, and most of the genes, they code for proteins. So, whenever DNA is expressed, proteins are produced. The expression is through two steps. First is transcription, second is translation, and the process is called as central dogma. So, let us start with transcription. In case of transcription, as we just discussed, transcription takes place to synthesize mRNA molecule from DNA. So, from DNA or chromosomal DNA, this mRNA molecule is produced. It carries message for the production of related protein, hence it is called as messenger RNA. In the process, as we discussed, it is called as transcription. In other or in simple words, transcription is a process where mRNA molecule is synthesized from the DNA template strand. So, as we know, this DNA, it is always a double-stranded helix. So, if this is a DNA molecule, it is a double-stranded helix, and this DNA, it possesses genes. So, genes, what are genes? Genes are the sequences present on DNA. These are the deoxyribonucleotide sequences present on DNA strands, which when expressed, proteins are produced. They are called as genes. So, when the genes are expressed, proteins are synthesized. This DNA, when, suppose that this is a DNA molecule with its two strands. If simply we present it in linear form, this type of structure it is. So, this is its polarity 5'-3', whereas the opposite strand in 3'-5' polarity. This is the oppositely directed polarity of the two strands. Suppose this strand is under expression, then genes are located on this DNA. They are transcribed to mRNA molecule. They are transcribed to mRNA molecule, and then the corresponding sequences there. Usually, this is a point to be noted that genes which are located near to each other, they are transcribed together, and a long mRNA molecule is produced. There is no separate production of mRNA for these two genes. A long common mRNA molecule is produced, which is called as polycistronic mRNA. This is polycistronic mRNA, which is found in prokaryotes particularly. It is found in prokaryotes. Since we are discussing prokaryotic transcription, this is a point to be noted. So, whenever DNA goes for transcription, this mRNA is produced. So, suppose that this is a DNA molecule. This is going for expression, and there will be production of mRNA by the process of transcription. So, and this is a gene which is under expression. This sequence on the gene is copied into mRNA molecule. Sequence on the gene is copied into mRNA molecule. So, suppose if this is a T on mRNA molecule, at the corresponding position, there will be A, because thymine pairs with adenine. If there is A on the corresponding position, there will be U. Why U? Why not T? Because in RNA molecules, thymine is absent. So, here, instead of thymine, there will be pairing with uracil. Then, if there is a C, here there will be G. Then, whatever it is, so let us say G, C, G. So, here will be C, G, C. So, corresponding sequence will appear on this strand of the mRNA molecule. Now you can understand that same sequence is present on this DNA, opposite DNA strand also. If this is a template strand, that is strand coding for mRNA synthesis, then this is actually sense strand. This opposite strand is called as sense strand, whereas this strand is called as antisense strand. Why this is sense strand? This is sense strand because it makes a sense how mRNA would be. Whatever sequence is there, same sequence is there, only difference is that instead of thymine there is always uracil, otherwise same sequence will be there. So here the sequence that I have written over here, that is of template strand. If we write sequence of this sense strand, then this thymine will bind with what? Adenine. Then this adenine will bind with thymine. This guanine here. This cytosine will bind with guanine. Guanine will bind with cytosine. Cytosine will bind with guanine. Guanine will bind with cytosine, and so on. So, if you say ATG, AUG, CGC, CGC. So only this base is different, otherwise remaining are same. So this strand makes a sense how the mRNA would be or what would be the sequence on mRNA. Hence it is called as sense strand, whereas strand which is under expression is called as template strand, or it is called as antisense strand, or it is also called as negative strand. Whereas this is sense strand, or it is also called as coding strand, or it is also called as plus strand. So now from this template strand, mRNA will be produced. Actually, there must be enzyme which has to play this role of addition of ribonucleotides. What is mRNA? It is a sequence of ribonucleotides. Okay, so ribonucleotides, they are arranged linked to each other, and always 5 dash end it attaches to 3 dash OH end. That is the direction of synthesis. So always 5 dash attaches to the 3 dash end. So if I am saying that this is how the synthesis is taking place, then here it would be, or this is the direction of synthesis, then of course it means that here there is 3-OH end, whereas this it is 5- end. It means that on this antisense strand, the condition will be this is 3-OH end and this is 5-N phosphate end. So this is how the orientation should be taken into consideration, or polarity should be taken into consideration. So mRNA is always synthesized in 5-to-3-N by the enzyme which plays a role in transcription is RNA polymerase. What is polymerization? It is addition of monomers which are linked with each other to form a long chain, that is called as a polymer. And enzyme which causes polymerization, that is a polymerase enzyme. So we know DNA polymerase is involved in DNA replication. Similarly, RNA polymerase is involved in transcription. However, this RNA polymerase is DNA dependent RNA polymerase or DNA directed RNA polymerase. Why it is called so? Directed RNA polymerase. So why it is called so? Because this RNA polymerase, it reads a sequence on template DNA strand and it adds RNA bases. So with reference to bases on DNA strand, RNA is synthesized by the enzyme. Hence it is called as DNA dependent or DNA directed RNA polymerase enzyme. This RNA polymerase, it itself is composed of different subunits. So this RNA polymerase is composed of different subunits, and these subunits are alpha 2, beta, beta dash, omega and sigma. These are the subunits of RNA polymerase holoenzyme. It is holoenzyme, whereas only alpha 2, beta, beta dash, it must be dash here, beta dash, omega, this is called as core enzyme. Actually, core enzyme is catalytic in nature. It is catalytic in nature. Means it carries out actual synthesis. It is involved in actual synthesis. So, what is the role of sigma then? This sigma factor, it actually leads core enzyme to bind at particular site, on DNA to initiate mRNA synthesis. This is important. Only that is the role of this sigma factor. So, it actually takes core enzyme to particular site to bind with DNA molecule. Now, DNA which has to be transcribed, suppose it is here, this is a DNA molecule which has to be transcribed, and this is a genetic region present on it. This gene has to be transcribed. Then this gene, it can be transcribed by core enzyme by binding on it anywhere in between. It can bind anywhere, so that wrong or faulty mRNA molecules will be produced. If core enzyme starts from here, transcription from here, what about this sequence? This is still there. It will not be transcribed into mRNA, and there will be faulty protein. There will be production of faulty mRNA and faulty protein. This is not afforded by the cell. So, gene must be transcribed from the very first base, which is denoted by plus 1. So, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, whatever the bases are, nitrogenous base I am saying. So, this first base must be transcribed, and all the bases should be there. According to the genetic code, there will be synthesis of complementary bases on the mRNA molecule, and then by translation in the polypeptide chain. So, this is the very first base that is present on the gene, and it must be transcribed. So, to transcribe this gene from its very first base, RNA polymerase, it binds somewhere here in this region. This is called as upstream region. So, this is its upstream region. This is its upstream region, whereas gene is present in downstream region. This is downstream region. From this, it is downstream region. Of course, for this we are talking. So, this is its downstream region. This is its upstream region. So, if a gene has to be expressed or has to be transcribed from plus 1 position, RNA polymerase should bind over here in the upstream side. And hence, to make this thing possible, there are certain bases present on this gene which are actually attracting RNA polymerase to bind at that site. And these bases, they are present in two conserved sequences or two conserved promoter elements. This region is called as promoter region. RNA polymerase to transcribe gene efficiently from its plus one position binds to particular region which is called as a promoter region, and this promoter region, it contains certain nucleotide sequences located at minus 10 position and minus 35 position. So what is this minus 10 and minus 35 position? From plus 1, all the bases which are present in the left side, they are denoted by minus letter. So this is minus 1. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So in that way, there will be minus 10 position and minus 35 position. 6 base pairs present over here. In this and this region, they are typical, and here it is T A T A A T sequence, which is called as minus 10 box. This sequence is called as minus 10 box. It is also called as Pribnow box. Pribnow discovered it, scientist Pribnow discovered it, hence it is also called as Pribnow box. Whereas at minus 35 site, the sequence is, this sequence is, let me use red pencil so that this is TTGACA. These are actually, that is this TATAAT and this TTGACA, these are actually called as consensus sequences. Almost in all bacteria in the promoter region, these typical sequences are present. Now, these are the ideal sequences for strong promoters. Strong promoters means what? Means promoters or DNA regions which are having these particular sequences. Besides this, one more thing is there, that in between this minus 35 and minus 10 region, there should be a distance of about 17 base pairs. It is about 17 base pairs. 16 to 18, but the average is 17 base pairs. Whereas the distance between this and this, it is about 5 to 8 base pairs. This is the ideal distance. So, strong promoters are those which possess TATAAT at minus 10 box, TTGACA at minus 35 box. Whereas distance between this plus 1 and minus 10, it must be of about 5 to 8 base pairs, and that between minus 10 and minus 35 box, it must be about 17 base pairs. If all these things are fulfilled by this DNA present or located in the upstream region of the gene is transcribed very efficiently. But the fact is that all the genes are not required all the time expressed very strongly. Some genes are such that their expression is required very few times or hardly sometimes, and that too in low concentration. In such cases, there should be weak expression of the genes, and for weak expression, promoters should also be weak promoter. Now, what is weak promoter then? Weak promoters are promoters. These are the promoters which show differences in these four required things. That means they may vary in the sequence TA, TA, AT. Instead of that, they may show sequence TA, TA, TT. A bit variation is there, but it affects its potential, or it may also vary over here. Instead of thymine, any other base it will be there, or it may vary in the distance between minus 10 minus 35 box. Instead of 17, it would be some more or some less. Similarly over here, if all these things happen, the promoter is said to be weak promoter. So RNA polymerase binds to this promoter very weakly, and thus expression is not strong. This is one of the regulatory mechanism. Some promoters, they must be weak. Some promoters must be strong according to the necessity of the expression of that gene and according to the necessity of that particular protein for that particular cell. So this is how everything is very nicely controlled. Now, RNA polymerase